I hear the flowers kind of crying loud. The breeze is sounding sad. Oh no, tell me when did we become so cold and empty inside? Lost away a long time ago. Did we really turn that blind? We don't see that we keep hurting each other, no. All we do is just fight. Now we share the same bright sun, the same round moon. Why don't we share the same love? Tell me why not? Life is shorter than most that thought.
In conversation with Dr. Joseph Noori on the Jumu'ah journey, soon to be the Journey Cape Town and SA's Heart and Soul broadcast on Cape Town TV with me, your host, Muhammad Junaid Shafika MJali. In the month of Ramadan, we're focusing on a number of issues. Doctor, last week we spoke of the spiritual benefits of the month of Ramadan, also the fact that staying away from food and drink, it will not necessarily harm the body. But now if you look at the physical benefits that can be attributed to a person who fasts during this holy month, elaborate on that.
Yes, there's a tremendous physical benefits for fasting. As I said, you know, right through the year, our bodies don't have a rest. We continuously consume food, and the digestive systems, the heart, all the various systems in your body, they have to, you know, work hard to digest the food. So a lot of energy is expended in this kind of these processes. Ramadan represents an excellent opportunity for these systems to take a break and regenerate themselves. So if you take, for example, a person that's fasting, his blood pressure, you'll find his blood pressure is normally lower than the other person who doesn't fast. His pulse rate is slower. You know, so in other words, his metabolic processes are all slowed down during fasting, which is tremendously beneficial for the body. So, and if you look at chemically, if you look at, from, for example, at our cholesterol levels and the fat levels, it also they are being steadied and lowered, you know, during the month of fasting. So tremendous benefits, as I said, physically, blood pressure wise, the pulse rate of the heart, and biochemically in your blood, all these things, they level down to a lower level than what you would expect otherwise when a person that's not fasting.
In terms of what we consume, Doctor, in the month of Ramadan, what would you advise for us to stay away from? And what would you advise for us to perhaps add to the meal in the evening when we sit down for iftar? Or perhaps what would be good to consume early in the morning for suhoor?
Well, general principles, again, as I said, don't overeat, you know, and eat what is nutritious. In the morning, I would suggest, I mean, a bowl of porridge. You know, it's fine. Some people you do with even, you know, less than that, you know, a slice of bread with maybe some tuna on, or a boiled egg with salads on, and a cup and a glass of water. That's more than sufficient. In the evening, you know, we should follow the sunnah of the Prophet, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We used to break his fast with a date and some water. And there's great wisdom in this. You know, the date is a wonderful fruit. You know, it contains high amounts of potassium, minerals, vitamins, almost no salt, almost no cholesterol, almost no sugar. No, enough sugar, but sugar in a way that is slowly releasing. It doesn't give you that spurt which refined sugars give you. So it gives you the energy that you need. You've been deprived of energy the whole day. Here the date is a concentrated form of energy. And it's a high fiber content also, giving your bowel a cleansing action. So an excellent fruit to break your fast with. And once you've broken your fast, you go make your salah, give your digestive system a time to kick in and to prepare for the main meal. And you sit down for the main meal again. Remember the principle, don't be excessive, small amounts of food. And some people consume maybe an extra vitamin a day, a vitamin pill. That's fine, that's accepted, it's not a problem. But if you eat healthy, then there's no need really to take these massive doses of vitamins. You know. So yes, that's basically what you should. There's nothing special about a special diet that you should follow. Just eat what is natural and shun what we create ourselves, you know, the refined foods, the kefir lines, and so on.
I'm about to lose the battle and cross the line. I'm about to make another mistake. And even though I try to stay away, everything around me keeps dragging me in.